In this video, we will learn about local binary patterns. About local binary patterns, we already discussed in this video, where we learn how we can calculate LBP values for different pixels. But till now, we just focus on how we can calculate the LBP value for the center pixel. Now, what about these corner pixels? Now, you can see on the corner, we have different pixels. So in this video, using an example, we will try to understand how we can calculate LBP value for these corner pixels. Second, we will discuss about multi-block local binary patterns. What are multi-block local binary patterns? Its advantages, disadvantages, and all. So first, we will start with digital image because we are going to work with digital images. About digital image, we all know it is a collection of pixels arranged in grids. Here you can see in this image, each pixel is a small color dot. For example, we are taking here this image. When we will zoom out this image, you can see the tiny square. They are the pixel, and each pixel has its own color, or we can say shade. And when we gather all these pixels together, it form whole image. Here you can see. So here we have grayscale images, color images. So grayscale image, that is the black and white image. Here each pixel has a shade from black to white. And in color images, each pixel is a mix of three basic color: red, green, blue. So digital images you can see on your phone, camera, computer, laptop. More pixel in any image means clearer and sharper it is. So in grayscale images, each pixel has an intensity value that range from 0 to 255. 0 represents black color, 255 represents white color. Second, we have color images, where color images use combination of red, green, blue to represent different color. So on screen only we have three color: red, green, blue. They are used. So by mixing RGB in different amounts, all other colors are created. For example, if you will mix red color with green, you will get yellow. And if you will mix red with blue, it will form purple. So every color you see on the screen is just the mixture of red, green, and blue. So digital images are used in different image processing and computer vision applications, because digital images help computer to understand and work with visual information just like our eyes do. Now next, we will focus on how local binary patterns work. LBP is very simple and effective, that is used in image processing to describe texture or pattern in any image. Now question is why we want to identify the texture or patterns in the images. LBP helps the computer to identify different patterns in any image, like smooth or bumpy surface. So in simple words, we can say LBP is a simple texture operator that we can use in different image processing and computer vision applications. So LBP is widely used in face recognition applications also, because it can easily detect the edges, spots, and other details, and it can easily extract the features, and it can create patterns, you can see here. And we can further use these features in data set to train machine learning models that can help the computer to perform different tasks like face recognition, object detection, and other. Now next, we will focus on how does LBP work, that we will try to understand using an example. Next, you can see we have binary patterns. We can represent any image using binary patterns, which has two possible values for each pixel, 0 and 1. Here you can see. So in binary pattern image, we have just two pixel values, either it is 0 or 1. 0 represents black and 1 represents white. Now next, how we can create binary patterns from any image. So first, we have a color image. We will convert this color image into grayscale image. Why? So that each pixel has single intensity value between 0 and 255. 0 represents black, 255 represents white. Each pixel has single intensity that range from 0 to 255. For example, we have this 5x5 grayscale image. Now here we will apply the threshold. We can select any threshold value. Suppose our threshold value is here 128. Now we will compare this threshold value with different pixels in this image. The pixel value is greater than the threshold value, then it will set to 1, else 0. For example, you can see here, first it will compare 200, pixel value we have 200, threshold value we have 128. So pixel value is greater than the threshold value, so we will set 1. So here we have now 1. Next, 150, it is also pixel value we have 150, it is also greater than threshold value, so set 1. Next we have 100, this pixel value is less than threshold value, so we will set 0. So like that we will compare the threshold value with each pixel and set the 0101 binary pattern. Here you can see the visual representation of this binary pattern. Now we have local binary pattern, that is also known as texture descriptor. Now we will discuss how local binary pattern work. As you can see in this example, create a simple binary image. You selected a threshold value. So how LBP work? LBP work by comparing each pixel with its neighboring pixel. So LBP will compare each pixel with its neighbor pixel values. So we have here neighborhood comparison. For example, we take out this 3x3 grid. Now in this 3x3 grid, you can see this is the center pixel and then we have the neighbor pixel. So LBP will compare the center pixel value with its surrounding neighbors. So in 3x3 grid, we have 8 neighbors. Now we will perform binary encoding where we will compare center pixel value with the surrounding pixels. If the neighbor pixel value is greater than or equal to center pixel, then it is encoded as 1. Else if the center pixel value is greater, then it is encoded as 0. Done. So how we will perform the comparison here? So here we will compare the center pixel value with the neighbors. If the neighbor pixel value is greater than the center pixel value, then it is encoded as 1. Else it is encoded as 0 when the center pixel value is greater than the neighbor pixel value. Now for example, we have this 3x3 grid and then this is the center pixel, we have 50 and we have 8 neighbor pixels. Now we will calculate the LBP code for this center pixel here. So now we perform the comparison. So now we will compare center pixel value, we have 50, top left neighbor we have 10. So when we will compare, you can see the neighbor is not brighter. So we will assign, so center pixel is greater. So we will assign here 0. Compare top center pixel. Here you can see 20. It is not greater than 50. So again, so it is encoded as 0. Next we have 30. It is also not brighter than the center pixel. So encoded as 0. Next we have 60. So this neighbor is brighter than the center pixel. Or we can say this value is greater than the center pixel, so it is encoded as 1. Next we have 90, this value is also encoded as 1. Then we have 80, it is also encoded as 1. 70, the value is greater than 50, so it is encoded as 1. Then we have 40, this pixel is not brighter than center pixel, so it is smaller than the center pixel value, so it is encoded as 0. Now we will convert this binary value into a decimal value. So here you can see we have this binary value. So position, you can see we will position and then calculate. So we obtain the decimal value, we have 30. So now you can see for the center pixel, we calculated value, that is 30. Like that we can calculate for all pixels. Now how we can calculate the corner pixel values. So here you can see in the corner pixel, some neighbors are missing. So how we can handle the corner pixel. Here you can see we have different techniques that we can use to handle the corner pixel. First we have zero padding, second mirror padding, third wrap around. So now we will discuss zero padding with an example. So when we want to calculate the LBP value for the pixels on the corner, here we need to consider the neighboring pixels since the corner pixels have fewer neighbors. And we can use here different techniques like padding, or we can say extension, to handle this situation. So first technique we have here, zero padding. This is the commonly used approach. So in zero padding, we assign a value of zero to the non-existent neighboring pixel. For example, the top left corner pixel ij, here the LBP calculation would consider the neighbors as 0, 0, 0 for the consider as this one. Then we have mirror padding. It reflects the existing neighboring pixels to the non-existent one. For example, for the top left corner pixel, the LBP calculation would consider the neighbors using this. Here you can see. Then we have wrap around. In wrap around, we consider the opposite side of the pixel as the neighbor. Now, for example, we will use this zero padding for this example. So before we calculated the value for this center pixel, now we will calculate the value for this corner pixel, 10. Now we will consider the neighbors who do not exist as 0. So we are using a zero padding. So we will assume the missing neighbor's value as the 0. After this, process is same. Now we will compare this 10, that is the, now this 10 become the center pixel. Now we will compare this with other. First we have top left, we have 0. 0 is less than 10, so center pixel is greater, so we will assign here 0, again 0. So like that we will compare all the pixels, and then we will form a binary string. So these binary values we can take either clockwise or counterclockwise. After that we will convert this into a decimal value. So like that we can calculate the values for all the pixels. Now next we have multi-block local binary pattern. Multi-block LVP is the extension of LBP. So this technique analyzes the image texture by comparing groups of pixels, that is blocks. In simple LVP, we compare pixel with its neighbor pixels, but in LVP, it compares blocks of pixels with each other instead of individual pixel. That is making it better in capturing large and meaningful patterns from any image. Using MBLVP, we can capture larger and more stable patterns by looking at the blocks instead of comparing individual pixels. So how this technique works? It divides the pixel into blocks. So the image is split into small blocks, that is like mini grids of pixels. Next, we will calculate the average value. Here, average value means for each block, we will calculate the average intensity, that is the brightness of all the pixels within that block. So within that block is calculated. Third step, we will compare the blocks. So we will compare the intensity of the central block to the average intensity of the blocks around it. So when we will compare the blocks, we will compare the average intensity of the blocks around it. After that, we will create a binary pattern. So if the neighboring block's average value greater than or equal to the central block average, then it is encoded as 1, else 0. Same we do in the LVP. Then we'll form the binary number. So here 1 and 0s are combined. Then we will form a binary number, which is then converted into a regular number, that is the decimal number, to represent the texture of that area. This is simple as LVP, but instead of comparing individual pixels, here we are comparing the blocks of pixels by calculating the average. Then the advantages of using MBLVP: by using block average instead of individual pixel values, MBLVP is less sensitive to noise in the image. Second advantage, if we have multi-scale analysis, because MBLVP capture texture information to different level of details, making it more effective for complex texture and patterns. Third, MBLVP is good at identifying the larger structure in images, such as facial feature in face recognition task. Applications where we can use MBLVP: for face recognition, it can capture facial texture at different scale that can improve the face recognition accuracy. Second, we can use in medical image analysis because it helps in analyzing the texture pattern that may indicate certain medical conditions. Third, we can use this for the object detection. So we can perform object detection based on the texture classification of the image. And how it works? First, we will divide the maze. So first, we will divide the maze into blocks. Second, we will calculate the block average. Third, we will select a central block. Then we will select a central block. Next, we will compare the neighboring blocks with the center block. After that, we will form a binary number. Then we will convert this binary number into a normal number, that is a decimal number. Then we can repeat this for all. Then we can apply this process across the entire image considering different central block to create a feature map or histogram that representing the texture of the image. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.